Hi guys, perhaps you remember my last video where I was showing that the brand new Dell 770 CTO, which I bought, just scorched within 30 minutes of use. This is a follow-up video on the situation. Last week, a Dell technician visited me trying to repair the Dell Precision 770. And actually, the reason it didn't work was not that it scorched, but instead that it suffered from a surge and a surge issue. And the remedy for this was to, the technician opened the Dell, removed the battery, connected the AC adapter, booted the Dell, which worked back again then he switched it off and reconnected the battery. So if any of you ever faces a situation where the Dell Precision 770 shuts off and all you get to see is a status LED blinking four times in yellow and one long blink of white repeatedly, then you know it's a surge situation. You need to open the Dell, remove the battery, launch with AC power, then shut off the Dell again and reconnect the battery. So it's working again now, but it is still not satisfying. Yesterday, I made a couple of benchmarks with the Dell Precision 770, and it still doesn't satisfy me. After running some benchmarks for only 60 minutes, the chassis got so hot. I have a digital thermometer pointing at it, and the digital thermometer was showing a temperature of almost 60 degrees Celsius. 60 degrees Celsius. Imagine 10 degrees more and you would get blisters on your fingers. Watch these temperatures. So I will not keep this Dell Precision 770. You can't use it. If it's getting so hot after even only using it for 60 minutes, then it definitely will not be able to operate for weeks. Imagine you have a 3D animation or even a 3D graphics, a complicated one, which renders a week or two of those, then it needs to run stable for weeks. This Dell Precision 770 doesn't even run stable for 60 minutes. When it got so hot, I got blue screens and many NVIDIA unexpected exceptions. So it's not stable at all. And it's definitely not worth the money. I do not recommend buying the Dell Precision 770. It's unstable, it's getting incredibly hot when it's been run, and it's not stable at all. And what's even worse, even though I bought the largest NVIDIA graphics card I could get, which is the A5500, the Dell Precision 770 renders slower than the very old NVIDIA GeForce 1080. Imagine that. The 1080 is years old and the latest NVIDIA graphics card renders slower than the GeForce 1080. So don't buy. So my conclusion is I'm going to return this piece of hardware to Dell. It's not worth the money. It's not worth 10,000 euros. For this amount of money, I would expect a stable, very well designed piece of hardware, but not this piece of metal.